because later you have to watch this video. Anybody wants to give brief about collection?
Yeah, hello. Collection is a framework that provides to store data and manipulate the group of objects like this.
Oh, what are the benefits?
It provides a ready-made framework.
Ready-made framework. Okay, anybody else?
Size is not limited, like in the heterogeneous data we can store it.
Yeah, it is a set of class and it provides lots of interface also.
Only this much you know about collection? Anybody else want to give some points like array list, set, map? Have you guys ever worked, anybody worked on collection, practiced on college days, later on, learning in Java? Nobody has idea.
Yes, array list, set, and hash map. Array list also, we have linked list and set, tree set, like that, and hash map is also there. So in array list, we can store all the values, and in set, we can have only non-duplicate values. And hash map is a pair of key and values.
Okay. You guys, anybody else has any idea? Okay. So to be very frank, if you have never worked on the collection, need to be more focused on that, right? Because whatever we have learned till date, everybody has a weak task to do, right? But if I talk about collections, then from here actually your course is starting, if I say, right? So your means 90% times you will be using collections in Selenium, right? So anybody missing, right, depending on videos, wasting time, then surely there will be problem in Selenium. Okay, so collection. See, to store data previously, what we have? To store data previously, we have array. Right? Sorry? So previously we have array to store data, but there was a problem with the array. And what was that problem? Array can store homogeneous data type. Means array can store singleton data type. Means what? If you are storing, if you are creating array type of integer, then only you can store integer values. If you are declaring type of string, then only you can store string values. Because array declaration was like this: int array is equal to new int. We will try to find out limitation by this line. See, now we have declared array type of integer, right? So what we can do, only integer values can be stored in this array, right? Here I have declared this size 5, then only 5 values can be stored, right? Suppose tomorrow, because a project will be dynamic, tomorrow 10 people coming, then this will be a problem, because only 5 integer values can be stored. And if 10 roll numbers or 10 integer values are coming, then how this array will manage that? No, it cannot manage that, because array cannot increase its memory and runtime, right? It cannot increase its space, right? To overcome with these problems, we have collections in Java, right? So collection is what? In our college days or later on, it, as per our need, we must have heard about the data structures, right? So people will collect data structures. Must have heard about this subject. It was in our syllabus during BTech or MCA, whatever you did, I don't know. So this was in syllabus, right? So we must have learned this subject, right? So what the data structure is actually, in data structure we have heard about the linked list, right? And stack, queue. You guys are not able to see my screen, everybody?
No, it's correct. Look good.
Means everybody can see this screen, right?
Yes, I am able to see.
Okay.
Yes, yes.
So there may be internet issue or something else in your side. If you are joining, anybody is joining from mobile, so don't switch over the screen. Sometime WhatsApp message is coming, we are switching to that WhatsApp message and then coming back to the Google Meet app, right? In that case, we'll miss the screen sharing. And this is a defect with the Google Meet as of now. So,
you disconnect and rejoin, then I think it's okay.
Right? Okay. So linked list, stack, you, this you have heard over there, right? Today we are today we will be understanding what is the collection, right? Revise those things and then directly we will extending these versions, because whatever we have learned in college days was not sufficient, right? So we will understand from very basic, right? What is collection? Collection is actually data structure in this Java, right? Which have some predefined libraries to implement data structure concepts. This is my definition. And the book is definition is that collection is a framework, collection is this and that. But for coding purpose, definition is this: collection is a data structure in Java which is providing you some predefined libraries to implementing data structure concepts, right? Of course, collection is an interface also inside the Java, and don't be confused with those things, right? See, now how many type of data structure you have? You have basically this data structure: list, set, map, stack, and queue, right? These you need to explore, and this I will cover, because many a times and 99% times we'll be using this, and most professionally will be using the array list, right? So in project we'll be using this, but we'll covering these two, right? Stack and queue. Once we'll cover the list, then set and map, then obviously the class name will be changed and you need to implement this concept. Stack is queue is what? List LIFO and FIFO, last in first out, first in first out, right? You need to revise these subjects and you will get to know, right? But just like someone said that sorting and searching methods are present with the collections, so not present with the array. For searching and sorting, you need to declare your own methods, your own logic for searching and sorting with the array, right? Bubble sort, this sort, that sort, right? I must have heard about these things. So we are going to learn collection, that part, whatever we needed for project, whatever we needed for the Selenium, right? And in very deep way, right? So, okay. So now, one more thing, whatever I have covered yet till now was actually related to that interview part, right? Why we collection, use collection. But actually, in real time, if someone says this question may be asked, if array is so bad, right? Array is so bad, just like array cannot declare memory in runtime, right? Array has limited in size. Int a is equal to new int at 5. If array is so bad, then why we don't go for the array list, or why we don't go for the collections? Because what is the substitute for array is array list in collection, right? And array list is part of list interface, right? So list interface has two implementing classes, array list, linked list, right? These are some these are two classes of list interface which are implementing this interface, array list and linked list. Because in interface, if you have to provide implementation of interface, then we were declaring classes for that. So here, for declaring for implementing this list interface, we have two implementing classes, linked list and array list, right? So if we want to implement this, suppose we are picking array list, right? So of course, array substitute of array is array list, right? So if this is too bad, if array is too bad that it cannot allocate memory on runtime, it is limited in size and can store only singleton data type, then why we don't go for the array list? Then why we look anytime, why we have studied the array? Why we don't directly study array list? Just remove this array from the Java concept. No, we cannot do this because what? See, you need to understand very carefully. See, what happened with array list? Suppose we have 5 elements. Today we have 5 elements, right? And what we do, we add these 5 elements in array list. Array list add 5 elements, right? Now tomorrow what happens? Tomorrow 5 more elements coming, so you will add 5 more, then 5 more coming, 5 more, because array list can increase in size on runtime. So you will be adding these elements on runtime. But there is a problem with the array list, right? And that problem you need to understand. What is that problem? Suppose I have added 10 elements, again 10 coming, so it will add 10 plus 10, 20. Suppose tomorrow one element again coming, so it will add plus 1 is equal to 21, right? But what it is in background, what it does in background, it, if one new element is coming, right, so what it will do, it will copy these 20 element in new array list. Compiler will create on background and it will copy these 20 elements in new array list. 20 elements copied in new array list, right? And then whatever new one is coming, it will add that to one, then 21 elements, right? And then previous one will be available for garbage collection, right? Suppose there are 10,000 elements, right? And then suppose there are 10,000 elements, then it will copy 10,000 element first, and then this next element it will be copying here, and then it will previous one will be available for garbage collection. Suppose there are 1 lakh elements, then it will copy 1 lakh elements one by one to the new array list which is created in background, and then a new element will be added, and then previous one will be available for garbage collection, right? And suppose this process runs 100 times in your project, right? Just because of you cannot stop anyone to add any element in runtime. There may be thousands of user in your website, and runtime these new elements are coming, and you are copying new to the array list, and then previous one will be available for garbage collection. So what it does, this process slow down the execution, right? If execution will be slowed down, then your performance of any tool or any website will be down, right? So suppose you go to the Facebook and you log in with the Facebook, and Facebook take 5 minutes to switch you to the home screen, right? Then will you ever use Facebook? No. Just because of performance, just because of UI we are seeing in the platforms, we are using those platforms, right? So that's why at that period of time this array list concept will not work for us. So now question comes, then array list is too bad, then why don't go for array? Because array has its own limitations with the size, right? Array cannot create size on runtime, right? So that's why we have to decide as per our need in our system, in our website. If the performance is the key point, right, then at that period of time we should use array. But if the memory safety, memory saving is our key point, then array list will be preferred. So combination of these both array and array list will be used. Suppose if we talk that we have a Excel sheet, and one by one we have to grab data, right? And in Excel sheet actually name and mobile number are stored. So if I'll say that need to check all the name and mobile numbers, then one by one you will pick from that Excel sheet and you will match, right? But if you automate that process, you not know how many people are in that Excel sheet, because suppose that Excel sheet is having filled dynamically, means some form data is coming to that Excel sheet. Just like we have shared you a Google form, you are filling that. I don't know how many people will be filling that form. So suppose if they have declared array for that, then that's the failure, right? So suppose in runtime the Excel sheet we have to automate, we don't know how many people are there. So how I will store the data of that Excel sheet? Using array list, not array, right? So based on your requirement you will go for array list, right, or array. Now let's try to use it practically. package and here array list. This is a list class. We don't want to use this parenthesis, don't use that. Okay, so this is array list. Now I said that array list can store any data type, right? So list object you need to use here, dot add method is there. Right, and you can see if you are using this add method, what it's saying, object, right? So array stores the primitive types, but array list by default convert it to the object, right? Note this point because we will use this point to explain something later on, right? So you just need to remember this, that whenever we are using the add method, list dot add method, then what it internally does, it converts that particular data into object, right? Suppose we have added Vandan, then we are adding roll number of Vandan, suppose 101. 101, right? So you can see this is a string and this is integer we have added. Suppose we want to add one more string, mobile number, then we will store like this. Okay, this is about adding element to the array list. Okay. Now, if you want to print this list, then you have two ways. First way is you can use the for each loop, right? Second way is that you can use for loop, simple for loop. So, for using, first we will talk about for loop. So, if you want to use for loop over here, so for loop concept is this, int I is equal to 0, automatically closes, I less than, suppose now as of now we take 5, right, just to not getting an error we are taking 5 here. So loop will run how many times? Loop will run 5 times, from 0 it will start 1, 2, 3, 4, but I am having only 3 elements and loop will run 5 times, then it's not good. Then how will you calculate the size of this, right? Suppose you say we are seeing 3 here, maybe tomorrow one more coming, then it will be 4, so can you put 4, or 3 here? No, just because we don't know what will be the size. For calculating the size of list, we have a method here. List is what object of this array list, dot size, right? So this size method will return us this size of the list, right? So if I store it inside integer size, size of list, then it will be returned. If you want to print, you can check that size of list, right? And then plus size of list. Size of list is what? 3, right? Because only three things I have added. Suppose I comment this line. So now what is the size of list? Size of list is 2 now. Let's run it. 2, right? So this size method will return you size of list, right? Just let's uncomment this line and here. Of course, this also. Here we will use list dot size, right? Instead of writing in this here and printing here, we are directly using inside for loop, right? So what it will return? It will return 3. So here dynamically it's written less than 3, right? So loop will run how many times? 3 times, because it is starting from 0. Okay, now I will print my list, right? But before printing inside for loop, let's print it here. Sysout list, right? And see, Vandan is printed because Vandan is part of list. 101 his roll number and 8869 mobile number, right? So this object is printed because you can see that this big brackets over here, right? So this is this printed whole object, right? So if you want to print one by one, right? So how can you print that? We have a method. See, in array, what was we doing? Suppose there was array. If I have declared int arr, I am comparing here to understand the differences, right? So it's not needed here, but it's still explaining so that you can relate it. New int 5, right? So if I was saying that how will you get second index element, so what was you doing? You was doing simply arr second index, but the 0 is first index and 1 is second index. If I was saying you get the value of third index, then you are putting 2 here, right? Similarly here also, let's remove it. Similarly here also we have a mechanism, but not like just arr 0. We have get method, because I said that we are getting from value from object, right? So from this object, any times, not only in this array list, not only in this collections, any times in Java, any case you see this, then if you want to get any value from these big brackets, you have to use get method, right? Get method is here like this. If I say to you that get me the value of this index, right? So this is what index? This is first index. So how will you get it? List dot get and provide index 1, because this is at 0 position and this is at what position? This is at first position, right? And just print it to make sure. Okay, so first this will be printed and then you are getting value from this value, then this will be printed, right? You can see 101 is printed, right? Now we got it, that list dot get method. Get method is there. So if anybody ask you that how you will get a value from an object, so simply you have to reply that we have get method to get any value from the object, right? And get method asks the index, so we need to provide the index of that, right? Now we have to print all these values, right? So just simply type this out, list dot get I. So first time I value will be 0, right? Second time I value will be 1, and third time I value will be 2. So all these three values will be printed. List dot get 0, list dot get I, get 1, list dot get 2, right? This is normal simple Java for loop, right? So it has printed me 1 then 1 0 1 and this, right? So if you will comment these lines, so you will get this. Right. Okay, so this is about adding element, this is about printing element, this is about getting the size. Now if you want to remove any element from the array list, remove element from array list, then how will you do that? There is a remove method, of course, right? So simply list dot remove, right, and provide the index. See, index is, suppose I want to remove this mobile number from here, right? So see, if you want to I suppose my mobile number is changed tomorrow, right? So first I have to remove that mobile number, then I will update, right? This is actually process. People directly update, that's not good. So first you need to remove that particular index, right? And then you need to provide new mobile number. Suppose, and this is at what position? 0, 1 and 2, right? So here I will do 2 and this will be removed. Now we can print our list. This out. Printing list after removing. Now here, this out. We need to print list. Simply just print this object, right? And then it. See, these three values were there. Now I have removed the mobile number. Printing list after removing. Then mobile number is not present inside this object. Let's comment it. This out list. Can see. First this value was there, and if I have removed something, then this is right. So this is about adding new elements. Okay, we have, okay, for each loop. Now see, this is done with the simple for loop, right? But really important concept is for each loop. How we will print the same list using for each loop. Yeah, of course. List dot add method for adding something, and list dot remove method for removing something. Size method is for getting the size, right? So for each loop, see, if you want to iterate over the objects, then we have a loop is for each loop. Just type for and control space, it will automatically create for you. But meanwhile, we'll write by your own. Just type for, right, and then see. First you need to have a semicolon over here. This is actually not semicolon, it's colon, right? And then see, what object you want to iterate over? What object you want to iterate over? I want to print all elements of this list. So copy this and paste after this colon, right? Always remember this. In this place, what should be coming? The object which are containing values. We have added value where? In this list object. So we should keep here list, right? Now what this list is containing? What data type the list is containing? What class type this list is containing? List is containing string. List is containing integer. Tomorrow may be double, float. You need to try after this session. So we are not sure what is containing here. Suppose we let's try to write here a string obj. It will give you error. Type mismatch cannot convert element type object to a string, right? If we want to store here integer, type mismatch cannot convert element type object to integer, right? Now, what should we do here? If child cannot do something, always father will remember only father, right? If his child is in trouble, then child says that father can do it for me. In Java, object class is the father of all classes. If nobody can handle, then object class will handle, right? Related to data types, right? Object, you need to create object here, obj. Okay. Now, open and close parenthesis just like simple for loop. This list object containing all the values, list dot add, all the values are added in the list object. So keep it here and then object, right? What this list object will do? Internally, one by one, it will copy value to this object, right? Currently, single values are added, primitive values are added, name, roll number, mobile number. So it will copy all these things one by one here, one by one. First, this one then will be copied from this list to object. Then once loop will be running, then again second time it will copy 101, third time it will copy mobile number, right? So you need to print this object just like we were printing here. Where is the for loop? Just like we are printing here list dot get I, right? So it is converting something like this only, right? So just let's print this object. And you can see that one then 101 and mobile number is printed, right? So object class will handle that, right? Now suppose in my case something only mobile number or only names are present or only emails are present here. Let me add here list dot add college to industry at the rate gmail.com. In my case, only any concern if you guys have, let me copy this email ID here. If we are not listening and something someone is not listening, not resolving your query, simply drop here, right? And you will get your query resolved within 24 hours, right? So suppose this email ID, right? So if I run this program, then of course all things will be printed, right? But let's remove this and make this type of a string. This is generics, okay? Means now you set to your array list, add only string kind of values, don't add any other data type. Then you need to provide generics in this angulars. right? So now if you will try to add any integer value, you will get error. The method add int string in the type array list string is not applicable for the argument int, right? It is saying that you have declared that I will add only string and you are adding the integer. It's not correct. Either remove this or remove this, right? So I am removing this as of now, right? Now you said that I have only string type of values, right? Or I have only string data type in my list. Now if you will type here a string, where it's gone, then you don't need father. I can handle this. Why we should go for father, right? Just run this. Okay, so this is about generics and list and whatever.
Yeah, hello.
Yes. If you want to add only the string kind of values, then you have to provide generics over here, because you are restricting to store this list for adding any other data type. Then we need to use
it is better na if we go without generic, then we store all value like the string, double float.
But if you have requirement, if you want to see, many times if you are submitting any form, then you must have seen that if you are storing any email ID, right? Or if you are in a mobile number field in a form, then if you want to submit your abc@gmail.com or abcdfg over there, it will not accept that mobile number, right? So will it be correct then? That's why we need to provide these restrictions sometimes. Let me check. Adding, getting particular index, removing generics, printing full array list. Yes.
Yeah, I have one question. In that case, we have always like roll number or whatever in the real time. If we have multiple letters like integer, float, string, whatever, then in that case, always we can prepare for object only.
Yeah, of course, in that case we need to have this data type. But see, once we'll talk about the class type of array list, then we'll see that, right? So class type will handle all that, right? But if there is a data handling in the same class and we don't have class type array list, like we can declare here as a student. Suppose here I will declare a student. Okay, keep this question here, right? And I will, because this is part of a syllabus. See, let me show you. If I have here, okay, see what happens if I have a student here, right? But this student is actually a class, right? So this student properties will be declared inside that student class, and we need to declare a student here, not the object, right? We'll cover that.
Sure, no problem.
Okay. So this is about today's agenda. If you have any query, drop in the Google Classroom. If anybody has not joined the Google Classroom, I will share the link here. This is your link. Just copy this link and join Google Classroom, right? Okay. Here you will get all your assignments.